we can foster their inspiration by using the techDetector and also sensitize them so they can position themselves towards future tech in the form of risk assessment or concerning new unknown technologies, and also get to know about methodologies on how to interact with technologies and with the future. So these are basically the challenges we were facing when we decided to build the techDetector, and we were very lucky to find Envisioning, who on one hand were very flexible and open-minded towards our focus on sustainability, which was new for them and also for other tech raiders on the market. Like, we are the first one actually that specifically focuses on technology, on sustainability. And together with Envisioning's experience and expertise and their great product, which is turned out to be the techDetector, we were able to build this and be in this amazing project. So maybe Arthur, you can tell a bit more about the side of Envisioning. Thanks.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for the intro. So my name is Arthur Soares. I'm also Brazilian, but based in Berlin. And I've been on Envisioning side since the beginning of the techDetector project. And today, what we're launching to you, that we're calling the platform, we are very happy to say that this is another step in the journey that this project has taken with GateSet and Envisioning. And we're quite excited with what it means for you. So we started the project in 2019, where we first were looking at a general overview of technologies that were impacting sustainable development. And this was the first step that really laid down the foundations for the work that we were doing. We started understanding the premises and the key areas that we had to do the research. We've developed two very interesting assessment metrics for the project. The first one is the sustainability impact metric, and the second one is the gender equality, gender impact metric that we're going to talk about later on. But what we are finally very happy to be able to accomplish with this new phase of the project that you will see in a second is that when we first launched on these two couple first steps that we've taken, we had a closed research. We did a lot of, we scouted technologies, we created some implications, we understood, and then we did a developed project. That was the end of the research. Envisioning by itself does keep up with the technologies and keep scouting and understanding what's changing with them, especially with its descriptions and its readiness level. But with the techDetector platform, the approach that we take is that it's a lot faster and it's able to keep up with the development that's happening. So the great thing of the techDetector is that it's an ongoing research platform that it's being updated frequently with new scenarios, with new topics and new areas of expertise or new challenges that are facing. So above all, I think the main premise is that this is open, as the links that you're seeing in the chat. So this is almost like a public utility for you all too. So that's my intro a bit on the project. The part that we have on the techDetector, it's structured in a pillar of three main things. So we still have the technology components, the applications, domains, and methods that you will see a bit more of this methodology in a second with Laura. We look at these technologies and then we frame them through stories. So we're looking at specific challenges that are coming partly from GateSet internal teams, either in terms of supply chain or in the specific projects. So we contextualize and do additional research on how those specific technologies can affect in a given scenario. And the third pillar of the whole project is that we're doing a lot of training and a lot of capacity building in terms of developing futures literacy and creating scenarios together with the teams to understand how these technologies can perform or can help a bit better. And also just mentioning a bit, we have a Q&A setting on Zoom. So if throughout the presentation you find that there are any key points that you have questions or you'd like to be addressed, just send a message and then we'll be answering in the midtime. And yes, that's it. I think we can, next up is Laura.
Thank you, Arthur, for the introduction. And my name is Laura Del Vecchio. I am the editor-in-chief at Envisioning. It's a pleasure to be here and welcome everyone. So as we already know, at least until now, we know the techDetector is an interactive platform designed to engage discussions related to the impact of emerging technologies on sustainable development. Inside the techDetector, the layers we have, you can navigate and quickly explore and understand, of course, how emerging technologies interact and apply in different situations. In the techDetector, there are two fronts, and we have the platform and the radar, okay, each one with different purposes. The platform is mainly concerned with analysis related to the technologies applying to specific contexts and are more focused on exploring domains and stories. We will look at this later on, not now. And now the radar allows navigation between technology applications and works as a link to the content added to the platform. Okay, so after a long process, we decided to refine our approach to the definition of technology by distinguishing technologies between domains, methods, and applications. This refinement process made us look at technologies differently, more on learning and observing the technical parameters and the segments that comprise a specific technology, giving us the means and, of course, the tools to define more in detail how these technologies behave and, of course, therefore, their classifications. Why is that? Well, our previous approach considered all technologies the same, whether they were just specific technologies, for example, an artificial intelligence therapist, or more broader fields of technologies, for example, artificial intelligence, which is a big branch that encompasses other technologies. So how can we measure the readiness level of artificial intelligence when, in fact, it is an entire field of study that encompasses many technologies inside of this entire field? So these made us believe that we needed to create a better categorization to our growing database and with a particular goal to make technological analysis more approachable and simplified. Well, so how this approach works, for example, if we look back in history and we look how technologies developed, if we look at the printing press, for example, they enabled progressive changes that boosted productivity and transformed the relationship society has with knowledge and propaganda, for example. So the evaluation of the impact of such technologies is only possible if we look at technologies applying to specific contexts and look at them as tools, things that we use to solve specific problems or to give us a way to specific goals. Currently, with digital tools igniting economic, political, social, environmental developments, and more specifically related to the hype and boom on how people now talk about technologies, emerging technologies within the branches, for example, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things, blockchain, are oftentimes misregarded and not really contextualized as objects that we can observe and analyze its development, and as we did, for example, with the printing press in the past. So with that in mind, how we classify these technologies? In our research process, we usually count with two different stages. We first count with discounting, is when we forecast these emerging technologies, and then we count with the assessment phase. When we scout technologies, we take into account three different categories. We have the technology domains, we have the technology methods, and technology applications. Well, the technology domains, they are the springboard for the development of other technological objects, such as methods and applications. Well, they similar to scientific fields of research, technology domains, they allow researchers to be inspired to develop new technologies and methods. So then we have the technology methods and differently from the technology domains, and of course applications too, they are technical procedures. In other words, they are ways of using technology to accomplish a certain task. So technology methods, they normally do not evolve throughout time. And if For example, if any segment of a specific technology method happens to change, it becomes a different method. So we do not use technology methods as a way to measure and to assess how it develops throughout time. So then finally, we have the technology applications, which are technological objects applied into specific contexts. Technology applications are the tools we use and are responsible for impacting our lives now and tomorrow. And as there are objects being applied into specific contexts, technology applications are the tools that that are worth being up to date with. The application of these objects, relies upon the specs of their components and, of course, the technical parameters in the segments that compress a specific technology application. We take technology applications to measure and to observe how their components and segments evolve throughout time. And then once we, for example, we forecast a technology application, it comes the time to assess how this technology application evolves throughout time. So we, in the radar, we count with several filters, allowing users to filter technology applications by TRL, which is the technology readiness level. We have the sustainability impact, the gender impact, and so on. And these filters are the result of an assessment process. Currently, we count with three main axes while assessing these technological objects. First, we have the technology readiness level, we have the sustainability impact, and also we have the gender impact too. The technology readiness level is a metric that shows the development stage of a technology application. It ranges from 1 to 9. The higher the ranking, the more they are technically ready. Then we have the sustainability impact. The sustainability impact, what is it? So the sustainability impact is a little bit more complicated, but it intends to evaluate the potential impact of emerging technologies in 4 different dimensions, and they are all related to sustainable development. We have economic, we have ecological, we have social and cross-cutting questions. Each dimension has 3 criteria that indicate questions with signals that outline how these criteria might come to life one day. So each dimension is rated by the GIZ team according to a -2 to +2 scale, in which the lowest score corresponds to a high negative impact and the highest score corresponds to a high positive impact. The arithmetic mean of the 3 criteria from each dimension is used as the final dimension score. Okay, so the sustainability score is calculated using this arithmetic average of all 4 dimension scores. So then we have the gender impact. What is it? Okay, so the gender impact is similar to the sustainability impact, but the difference is that it tends to assess the potential impact emerging technologies have on gender equality. The metric was designed to measure 3 main vectors. And well, the first vector is how can we evaluate the positive or the negative technological footprint produced by a particular technology. Then we have a second vector where we analyze how a particular technology may help enhance data monitoring systems and how these monitoring systems can help push forward the redistribution of opportunities and resources among everyone despite their gender. And then finally, we have the final vector, which helps us evaluate how emerging technologies can help alleviate preconceived societal forms such as unconscious gender bias. Each dimension of the gender impact is rated by the GIZ team too, and the scale goes from -2, which is a highly negative impact, or it can be said, in other words, when there are gender-based disadvantages, and to +2, which is a highly positive impact, one that goes towards gender equality. All dimensions are divided into 2 categories. Resources, for instance, is divided into productive and financial resources and educational resources. And each category contains 1 question covering 3 main vectors. Well, the 3 main vectors I mentioned previously. So I would like to invite you to have a look on how the radar works, because it will give you a better picture of everything that I said so far. I know it's a lot to take in, but if we could have a look on how the radar behaves, we could show you some features of how it works. I know it's a lot to take in. It's a lot of information. Okay, so here is the radar. So with the techDetector, our team developed a focus mode that automatically zoom in a technology depending on what you have, on what you want to see. And all technologies, they allow users to quickly modify the technology application of the radar according to what they want to see. All technology applications, they count with technology readiness level. You can use this as a filter to select only technology applications with high TRL or low TRL. It depends on your needs. Also in the, exactly. Yeah, you can just use this to filter the technologies you want to see that, depending on your needs. If you want to have a look on technologies that are closer to our reality, then you set technologies that they have a higher TRL score. And then also you can use the filter to select technologies based on other categories and assessments that we previously did. So as we have the sustainability impact, we had the gender impact, we also count with the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And all these filtering options allow you to observe technology applications that are more made to measure for your project and help you compare these technology applications between your needs too. So for example, when there is one specific feature that we added to the filters too, is that to make also the exploration in the techDetector even more straightforward is the sector, which is the areas of expertise within Gears Act sectoral divisions. They serve as an additional qualitative indicator to all objects added to the techDetector. Sectors, they count with topics inside of the sectors. The social development sector, for example, has 19 topics that range from education to global finance. And you can also look at these aspects on the sectors to make your search even more tailored to your needs. So let's pick one technology. We can look at the blockchain domain, and then we can discuss a little bit what the domains provide to us and what we can see within that domain. So we can look at, okay, so the blockchain. Great. Thank you, Chiara. So if you're interested in having a broader view of technology, you can access from a technology domain, which is located in the platform. So then you move from the radar and then you go to the platform. From the domain, you can dive deep into an up-to-date analysis and check out all the methods and applications related to that specific domain. In this case, we look at the blockchain. So within the domains, applications are categorized according to their TRL. If we go a little bit more down in the bottom, then we can see the current applications, which are technologies at prototype and product stages. And then we can also find the future applications, which are technologies at the concept, proof of concept and validation stages. If we look at the current applications, we can choose the blockchain certificate, for example, just to have a look on what we can find in there. Okay, So the blockchain certificate, you will see a short description, then a full description describing what this technology can do. And this database works as an encyclopedia for you to assess all the information you want to know about that specific technology. You can also check the related content, links and organizations and all information involved and of interest when related to that technology. Okay, so inside of that specific technology, you can also find the stories related to that technology application. And I think this is a second topic related to the stories. I'm seeing the presentation. I'm seeing the presentation.
Yeah, it's for you to introduce the stories.
Yeah. But it's on the back end. It's on the back end of everything. Let's see. Great. Okay, so if we can pick, you can click on the digital twins, for example, and I can give you an overview of how this works on the right side. Okay. It was featured there in the blockchain certificate. Digital twins, the link, digital twins, the link towards sustainability. Great, thank you, Chiara. So, okay, great. So when you see the stories, they are the other part of the techDetector, because as I mentioned previously, I was explaining how the reader works, and then we have the platform. In the platform, you can check also these technology applications, but you can also check the stories. The stories are narratives that describe how these emerging technologies featured in the radar behave when applied to specific circumstances and industries, from future scenarios to case studies. We illustrate the impact of emerging technologies through these stories. Okay, so in this case, we are not in the digital twins case anymore. Okay, we are going back there. Okay, so as you can see here, this is a case study which we defined also the methodology for writing this entire piece. The case studies, they are the presentation and analysis of use cases related to specific technology domains, methods, and applications being deployed related to opportunities and challenges that some industries may face in the future. And then we try to address all these specific challenges and opportunities that we find throughout the research processes. And in this case study specifically, I tried to analyze the potential impact of emerging technologies involved in the development and design of digital twins, a framework that works as a virtual representation of particular products and assets, portfolios, or entire environments. I give some prominent use cases employing digital twins throughout the world. We have the Singapore virtual town, we have the pace setter, and we have also other examples related to sustainability, as for example, a blockchain solution that was created to provide an in-depth review of the conflict stones industry in Africa. And then we have a review of the European Green Deal landmark action that designed the destination of an information framework intended to create enough digital, a digital replica of the entire world, intended to help the world shift from energy intensive practices to approach zero waste and zero contamination. And if we move into other formats we have in our database and now in the techDetector, you will be able to find also future scenarios. You will be able to find sci-fi chronicles and interviews. The future scenarios, they are illustrative narratives based on the convergence of technology domains, methods, and applications, and are designed to be more provocative and inspiring. And these scenarios, they provide an argumentative piece that works as a guideline for you to explore how emerging technologies may impact our daily life in the future, in the years to come. Then you all will be also able to find Sci-Fi Chronicles. The Sci-Fi Chronicles, they are short fictional stories about the future, and they bring up real technology domains, methods, and applications within a narrative and present their dystopic and utopic inclinations. And finally, we have the interviews. These are texts based on a structured conversation presenting on a specific industry, and an industry expert in this case, where we investigate their expertise and a personal take on a subject we decide to work with. Okay, so what kind of format are you more interested in reading if you could decide which format you would like to work with? Let's see. Okay. So finally, I think it's a lot to take in. It's a lot of information. And I think the best way to illustrate what we've been doing is to showcase what we are going to display in the techDetector in the following weeks. Okay, so I have the results from the polling. I don't have the results anymore. It disappeared. Okay, so I can see we have 9% decided to choose a technologies list, 20% a case study, 4% an expert interview, feature scenarios 49%, and a Sci-Fi Chronicle is 18%. I think we have a winner here. And I think we have to develop more feature scenarios then. So to illustrate what we are going to display in our platform, I would like to invite Ariana Montero. She's a senior researcher at Envisioning, and she's been working on new pieces that will be displaying in our platform really, really, really soon. And I hope you all are very excited to hear from her, as I am. Thank you, Ariana.
Thank you, Lau. Thank you, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. I am Ariana Monteiro. I'm a senior researcher at Envisioning, and I'm currently based in Accra, Ghana. And for me, it's a very special day because I was involved with the techDetector in so many levels. So this launch comes to me with great joy. So I would like to share with you a little bit of our process now. And before we get into the process, I would like to share one of my biggest concerns from all these years working with emerging technologies, which is, even though technologies have shaped our habitat for such a long time, technology itself is not a force of nature. So why we keep pushing innovations that are typically incremental rather than transformational, right? So when I was kicking off on this research, particular research, I bump up with some results from an international research consortium called SETIS 2030. And it is related with innovation in agriculture. So my investigation here is, how can data become cash crop for small farmers? And in this consortium results, I found some alarming stats, which is more than 95% of publications at the Nature Research platform, for example, were not relevant to the needs of the smallholder farmers and the families. And most of those studies did not involve participation from farmers, for example, during the research. So my primary research question here in this investigation would be like, does data monetization among smallholder farmers has the potential to break the cycle and promote sustainable development for all, but especially for those who are in the primary source of value of production in agriculture, which is smallholder farmers themselves. So how do we know what's appropriate for them? Well, and as you can see, it's not a simple question. And when we are talking about data, data is a topic that comprises many gray areas. So that's why for this particular topic, we invite some amazing individuals who are experts and think linking data rights and agricultural development from bottom-up approaches. That means with smallholder farmers at the core of their innovation proposals. Either these innovations are software innovations or policy innovations. Well, with them, I had the opportunity to speculate about combinations of policy and technology that might create the foundation for build better digital solutions for rural communities around the world. Because one of our most significant learnings when talking with those experts is the focus should be on control, access, and use of data information by farmers and for farmers. Because so far, it is a combination of both political will and corporate interests that systematically excludes the smallholder farmers from the design of technical solutions. So that's why we see this discompact of innovations and the people that should be using them. So one of my speculations is, so what if the governments of the world pull together to make sure that every single smallholder farmer in the world is digitally connected and has inalienable rights to anything they use to the global data marketplaces. From a technical point of view, we already have appropriate technologies to advance in this scenario. You can see them at the techDetector. The problem is the absence of good data frameworks and digital strategies, especially regarding agriculture. So to learn how can we move forward from here, I invite you all to read my article that will be published at the techDetector next week. So this is it. Thank you.
Amazing. Thank you, Ari. I'm looking forward to reading your piece. And now talking with the participants, I would love to know in the chat, what stories would you like to read next at the techDetector? And while you guys are thinking about it, I will present the last but not least part of the techDetector platform. So we have introduced the radar, which is our tool for assessing and finding emerging technologies. We have the stories, which are these amazing investigations that can replicate a bit of the impact, can anticipate a bit the impact of these technologies. And finally, we have the techDetector Academy. So basically we have a lot of workshops and masterclasses that help people engage with the techDetector. And they are really special because it's a complete interactive experience where you can learn a bit more about emerging technologies that the techDetector offer, but also reflect on them. So I will talk a little bit about how this full course on futures literacy and technology works on our site. So we have three levels. We have an introductory level, second level, an intermediary level, which is designed for participants to quickly understand technologies, but also assess them and understand their impact. And thirdly, we have a futures development level in which participants are invited to not only look at emerging technologies, but really see through conversations with experts and science fiction, how they could create solutions for these future challenges and future opportunities as well. So giving a little bit of a brief introduction, let's dive a little bit deeper on the modules. So the first level, as I said, is an introductory level, which is the techDetector platform. The future starts here. And the future really starts there because we give a full tutorial on the tool, and also we showcase how futures literacy is important for sustainable development specifically, which is really important for us to have everybody on the same pace. And as for the second level, which is technologies discovery, we have two workshops, two experiences. The first one is the Tech Explorer. So the Tech Explorer is a game-like workshop that helps you quickly learn the technologies from the techDetector. So this is a game in which we provide mini challenges for groups, and they almost like compete to find the best technologies from the tech detector to achieve these small challenges. And this engaged them in learning dozens of emerging technologies in a single session of 90 minutes. So that's a really interesting take for people who want to know broadly a lot of technologies in a single session. And you can also play with your friends as well. And secondly, the second part, the second level, which is also discovering about new emerging technologies, is the tech impact. So the tech impact has a different focus. We focus only on a few emerging technologies, not the entire tech detector tool. And we investigate their effects on sustainable development or gender impact. And they are developed for groups to work together to create this assessment. So they are able to understand a little bit more about the technology they will be assessing. And also we have developed all these questions that help them engage a little bit more with the impact in the future of this innovation as well. So what happens in this workshop goes directly into the radar afterwards. So you can see the outputs of this workshop in the metrics you see in the radar as well. And we also develop insights reports with everybody's thoughts on it. And thirdly, and my favorite part at least, is the level 3, which is futures development. And futures development, we also have two workshops to work on. And the first one is the tech journey. And the tech journey is a really a journey, which immerses participants in a science fiction, science fact future that they need to create solutions to in groups. So for example, here we can set the scene in 2030, and suddenly we don't have the Amazon forest anymore, or we have half of the world flooded. In these type of scenarios, together with all the canvases we create and the tool of the tech detector, help inspire participants in creating these solutions for the future. So that's really interesting. You can also check the report of this workshop here in the QR code, or also in the link in the chat. And basically we create emerging and amazing solutions using the tech detector tool plus a very engaging future scenario. And last but not least, we have the tech roundtable, which gathers experts to discuss the future of certain industries. So basically, we're able to here anticipate a bit the obstacles that future developments might bring us to us, and also examine upcoming disruptions in sectors of interest. So this is really nice. It's you can check a lot of these tech roundtables on our YouTube channel. They are available online. And just for us to have a quick wrap up, now wrapping up all the conversations we had, I just would like to emphasize that the Tech Detector is a platform precisely because it has in a single form as stories for you to read, a tool for you to get access to those emerging technologies, and also the academy, which allows you to train to use the technology radar and also develop your own stories. So this project has been gaining a lot of interest. We have been incredibly lucky on the amount of people that are interested in getting together.
And we are especially thrilled today. The gender metric developed by GIZ, incorporated throughout our tech detector, was selected to be showcased in the 2021st Paris Peace Forum. So I hope to see you there. And we're really glad with this news from GIZ. Congrats, guys.
Now for this final minutes that we have, we still have 10 minutes. I would love to hear your questions and maybe bring all speakers together so we can talk a little bit further on the tech detector and see what people are asking us. So let's see, do we have any questions?
Yeah, I think the first one, everyone's asking for the QR codes for the links that you presented, Tiara. So maybe we can just post them on the chat or make a slide in the end, Yasmin, with the texts.
So any other questions? What kind of feature you can see from democracies? Do you have stories covering the subject? Yeah, we do have stories covering the subject of the future of democracy. You can filter the stories to check them on. But this is for sure a topic that we want to investigate more, especially counting on the year we're in. Arthur, would you like to, Arthur, Michelle, Laura, Ari, would you like to add anything else? I don't see many questions popping up.
If you're interested, we are updating the tech detector really constantly. And recently we published a new article that is related to one of the workshops that our proprietary workshops. And if you're interested, you can look at the tech detector and through the story section, and you can check all the stories that have been recently published. We are really proud of them because it's a collective effort from our research team and also with GIZ. And everything it's written by one person, but behind this person, there is an entire team of experts and people interested in bridging the gap between emerging technologies and sustainable development. All of them cover these topics, and we are eager to hear from all of you your opinions about these articles and to make them even more interesting, because we know that diversity is what makes everything more complete. And yeah.
So we also have upcoming stories. Not only Ari will be showcasing her story this week, but on the upcoming weeks, we also have stories related to the future of combustion engine, which is what was written by Lydia Zwing, which is an amazing journalist and also sci-fi writer. And Beatriz Rodriguez will be writing for us about distance learning and how we can create a closer learning without not necessarily relying on digital transformations. So really eager to check these stories as well. And with that said, I would like to thank you, all of you, for this participation. We will love to hear your feedbacks and thoughts about it. Let us know what stories you would like to read next. And we have three invitations for you, which will be posted in the chat. If you would like to build your own platform, you're interested in that, you can email us on hello@envisioning.io. And if you like to have an updated view of what is happening in our community, you can go to envisioning.io/welcome and join our Slack channel, where you can keep up to date with everything we are publishing and even get in our network of experts, researchers, writers, developers, etc. So thank you very much.